counselor.
Admiral, ladies and gentlemen, allow me to introduce you to the newest version of a very old friend.
With an upgrade, I'm told.
Oh, I am mostly myself, I assure you, albeit with a dash of computational joie de vivre.
The last time we spoke, you wished to experience death. As happy as I am that you're here, I hope that we haven't betrayed that wish.
No, sir. I know that me is resting peacefully. But this me would rather be no place else in the universe.
Join us.
It's been a long time since we all sat around a table like this.
Too long, really. By far.
I am so grateful to be here. Hardship may have brought me here, but I want you all to know that there wasn't a day all those years that I didn't miss all of you.
And we missed you too. I even found myself talking to you on my darkest days. Well, on my happiest ones too. It turns out you give really good advice even when you're not there. So you were always in my heart when it mattered.
I have slaughtered countless enemies over the years and considered sending their heads to all of you. But I was advised that that was passive aggressive.
All that matters is that we are together once more. Because I need you. All of you. Changelings have infiltrated Starfleet.
Whatever it is they've got planned, Frontier Day is just hours away.
And we've got almost no answers. We're analyzing the data that we pulled from the Shrike to see what it was that they were extracting from your body.
If I may, this is all factual information that ignores an emotional truth.
One which I felt the moment I set foot on this vessel. Whatever the changelings have in store for Frontier Day is tied directly to Jack.
There's something happening to him. Visions, voices. He has abilities that we just can't explain.
And whatever the cause, it is getting stronger.
There's a darkness with that boy. Not in him, but around him, passing through him, and a voice inside him, ancient and weak, but a voice that isn't his own. I think it's time I met your son.